Okay, so now that you have figured out this midpoint Riemann sum, I want you to try page 300, number 63. Okay, 300, number 63. So that's what we're looking for. I should have put that problem in here, but I didn't have time to, so I'll try to make sure I do that next time. So give that a shot, pause the video, give it a go, and we will continue on. You can see the answer in the back of the book. All right, so let's talk about integrals and how they have to do with area, okay? Because you know integrals are going to be connected to this. So you should have this in front of you. What I'm trying to tell you is that this area from A to B, this red area is represented by the following. This is equal to the integral from A to B of f of x dx. So if you integrate a graph from A to B, you get the area underneath the curve of that graph. So it's the area from A to B under the curve above the x-axis. And the area, if it's below the x-axis, actually comes out negative. I don't know that we're going to get into that today, but that would actually come out negative. So let's kind of talk about some properties. This is important because this integral symbol here, it kind of looks like an S, doesn't it? And it really means the sum. You're adding up all of those bars. You're adding up a million, billion, trillion, you're adding up infinite bars to get the exact area underneath the graph. So let's talk about getting the integral of these things. So how could we do that? Well, let's look at the first one, for example. Okay, so we have the integral from 1 to 3 of 4 dx. Well, what does that graph look like? We know that that's the graph of y equals 1, 2, 3, 4 here. So this is what the graph looks like. This is what it looks like. It looks like this, okay? A little bit higher than that, but it looks generally like that, okay? And we want to know the integral from 1 to 3, so we want to start at 1. We want to end at 3, so we're looking for this area. So what do you think the integral from 1 to 3 of 4 is? It's really just that area. What is the area of that rectangle underneath the graph of y equals 4, from 1 to 3? Well, it's 2 by 4, and that integral is 8. The answer to A is 8. So look at this one, okay? I'm going to draw it out for you, then I want you to think about it for a minute. Okay, it's the integral from 0 to 3. So we're starting at 0, we're ending at 3. So let's make this 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is 3. And we have this line that's like y equals x plus 2, basically. So we're going to go up to 2. And we're going to have a slope of 1, so we're going to be here, basically, we're going to be here. Looks like we're going to have something that looks like kind of like this-ish. And we want to figure out the area from 0 to 3, so we're going to figure out from here, 0, to 3 here, what is this area? Well, I guess we need to know some things. It's a trapezoid, isn't it? So we could lay this trapezoid down like so. Okay, and what would be the base of this trapezoid? Well, we know that this here is 2. We said it was 2. We know that this here is 3, 0 to 3, this is 2. What's this other one? Because the area of a trapezoid is 1 half base 1 plus base 2 times height. Take the two bases, add them up, and divide by 2. So you average the bases, and then you multiply by the height. Well, we need to figure out what this is. So 3 goes to what number? What is this distance here? We can just plug it into the graph. So you put 3 in here, you get a value of 5. So this is 5, that distance. So if you take that, and you do the area of the trapezoid, you get 1 half of 7, because you have those bases, and you multiply that by 3. So that's 21 over 2. That's the area. So the answer to B is 21 divided by 2. Okay. Lastly, this figure is a circle, I believe. So this is a circle. And we will skip it just because we don't want to get into too much about circles right now. We'll get into those later. But we just want to get a general idea of the areas. All right, so what do all these things mean? Well, this first thing means that if you had a function, right, and you wanted to know the area from this value to this value, well, how wide is your area? What's your base? What's the width of your base if you're going from A to A? It's zero. So the area is zero. This is what this is saying. Next property is kind of interesting. It's basically saying that if you go on a graph and you get the area from A to B, okay, and you figure out what that is, this area right here, okay? All right, so let's say this was like, let's say this was like 4, okay? And we don't know what this whole thing is, but let's just say this area, for the sake of argument, is like, 20, okay? It's 4 by like 5-ish. But now you take this and you realize that if you switch it from A to B and you start at A and you go to B, instead you start at B and you go to A. So instead of starting at A and going to B, which would kind of be like this, like that, which is positive 4. Instead, you start at B and go to A. That's kind of like taking the base and making it negative 4. You're starting from this side and you're moving this direction. Right? When you go this direction, you are having a negative base. And you have a positive height because you're above the x-axis. This is obviously a positive number. So that is going to give you a negative area. A negative base times a positive height. So if you switch the, these are called the boundaries of integration. So if you integrate from right to left, you're going to get a negative version of that integral. So anytime those are switched, it just, you can put a negative in front of that area. Okay, so that's where we are so far. Just kind of keep going here. Try to clean this up a bit. So I'm going to take some of these things off. Okay. So let's keep working it. Okay. Focusing on 3 now. So let's look at 3. So 3 says that if you take, this is basically just saying you can take a constant out of an integral. So, like, I don't want to get into the geometric version of this. There is a geometric reason for this, but basically what I'm saying is the integral of 5x squared dx is equal to 5 the integral of x squared dx. So you can pull that constant out. Okay, that's what number 3 is saying. We're not going to get into the geometric reason. You cannot pull an x out. You cannot pull it out any variable. So please, I'm very much trying to stress that. You see the tone in my voice? You cannot pull a variable out of the integral, just a constant. Okay. Also, same thing with integration is when you, just like with derivatives, if you have 2x squared plus 3x to the fifth plus ln of x, and you want to integrate that, and it's kind of hard, you can just make it the integral of 2x squared dx plus the integral of 3x to the fifth dx plus the integral of ln of x dx. So you can make it into 3 different problems. So a sum or a difference, subtraction or addition. You can separate it out. Which means you can add areas too. So like, I guess that means, actually it kind of is showing you here. So if you wanted to call this C, and call this, let's call this like 8, call that area 8. Well, what do you think the integral from A to C is going to be? So the integral from A to C of f of x dx. What do you think that's going to be? Well, we know that from A to B it's 20, and from B to C it's 8, so the integral is going to be 28. You're going to add up those two areas. The area from A to B and the area from B to C gives you the area from A to C. So we're going to have some examples where you're just kind of working those problems and just kind of taking it as far as you can take it. Hold on one second. So I'm not going to go through every example. We can go through some as time goes on. These are kind of the examples you're going to be using what I've done was, let's see, for example here, the first one, we gotta evaluate this integral. But this integral starts at pi and ends at pi, so how wide is the base of that area? That integral. That base is zero. This whole integral is zero. There's no area there. Now this integral from 0 to 3, it's a little weird. So it's this graph, which is up 2, the slope of 1, and we want to go from, I don't know, 1, 2, 3, so from here. We want to know this area here, I guess, right here. But we want to go from 3 to 0, so that, I mean, I guess, this number should be lower. In normal circumstances, the lower integration, this is the lower number, so it should really be 0 to 3. If it was 0 to 3, we could figure out this area. The area of that trapezoid, right? We can figure that out pretty easily. I think we did it in another example even. So I think it's, let's see, its base is 3, or its height is 3, and then it's 1/2 base 1 plus base 2, which I think in this case is 2 plus 5, I could be wrong. So that's 7, so that's 21 over 2. That's the area of the trapezoid. But because of this issue here, we want to put the lower number on the bottom, and that makes it a negative integral of this. Right? There should be parentheses here, but I don't put them in very often. But technically, these parentheses are supposed to be here, and not a lot of people put them in, but they're supposed to be there every time you integrate. So now we know that it's going to be negative the area of that trapezoid, which is 21 over 2, but note the negative. So a couple more examples. This is an additive one. We won't go over this example right now. It's the absolute value of x, so you can actually break it into two different areas, make it into two different lines. We'll talk about integrating absolute value. Think about it for a little bit. Think about finding the integral or the area under the curve of this, how you would do it. You'd find this area, right? You'd find this area, and you'd be good to go. Okay. This one is basically the same idea. What they've done here is they've kind of told you here what the things work out to. So anytime you get this, you can replace with this, okay? So let's look at this first example. What they're trying to show you is that you can go here and you have this, and it's pretty close to what you need because we just broke this. I stopped here. And I'm saying, okay, well, this is almost that blue thing. So I'm going to take that negative out because I can pull out a constant. And I really have negative, and then whatever that blue thing said it was, which is 26 over 3. That's the first part of this, right? Now we got to continue on because we've only gone up to the red line. Now we got to talk about this. Well, it's positive 4x. It's the integral from 1 to 3. So it's positive. The integral from 1 to 3 is 4x. Well, we'd like it to be just x, see that? So let's take this 4 out completely, and now we have the integral of just x. What's the integral of just x? Well, it's 4, but we have to multiply that by 4, because this is 4 right here, and so we have 16 for this. So that's that second part. And then lastly, we have this negative 3. So we have the integral from 1 to 3, we're adding that. Or no, we're subtracting. Well, what are we doing? We're subtracting, I guess. Subtracting the integral from 1 to 3 of 3 dx. But we don't want 3 dx, we want just this. We just want dx, so take the 3 out. What is that integral? Well, that integral is going to come out to 2. We have negative 3 times 2, which is negative 6. And our total answer for this thing is going to be the same as all of these. So we've got 16 minus 6, which is 10 minus 26 over 3. I'm not going to simplify it right this moment. Not that it's that hard, but just for the sake of time. So we'll stop there for now. It's enough for this video.